people's ministries, and Marco will call or Jessica will call and whatever they might need. There's always those last minute things, and then I have the pleasure of running upstairs and say, Pastor, I know it's only a day, but can we get this done? And I go run to Lorraine, and so we make it happen for our kids. Now I have the pleasure, as we continue, we're going to present each club as a group. So we're going to start with our rainbows. We're going to ask our rainbows to stand up with their leaders and come on up so we can recognize you.
These are our rainbow guys, and we did, we learned our pledge as a rainbow. I will be a good helper, and our colors are green and white, which stand for growing in purity, and my daughter wants me. But they've earned 9 units this year, where they did, and we did it based on different animals, the sheep and the cat, and sorry, my eyes are focused on a little person right now. And so they did little projects. They've memorized 9 different verses, and they've done a great job. And I'm very proud of them.
Big round of applause for our daisies, our rainbows. You may be seated. And we have 4 graduating to daisies in September. Next, we're going to ask our honor daisies to come up with their leader. These are our honor daisies. Look how beautiful.
God, keep your hand upon me.
Keep your hand upon me.
To be an honor daisy, you have to complete 9 units, memorize your scripture, do your activity pages, 4 weeks worth of activity pages all year long. And these girls have done it. They are an honor daisy. They are honor daisies. They have done their work. They have proved themselves. And that's why they stand here today. We have 3 honor daisies. We have Janice, Jasmine, and Leilani. We present to you our honor daisies for 2012-2013, Girls Ministries.
Next, we're going to ask our Ranger kids and our Discovery Rangers to come on up. Come on up. Let's give these boys a big hand. Look how handsome. Wow, what a group. This is a large group. Ranger Kids and Discovery Rangers.
First row are my boys. They're Ranger Kids. They go from kindergarten to second grade. This year we learned tying knots. We did safety courses on how to practice fire drills in our churches and our homes, right? We did home helpers. Some of these kids had to do chores in their homes. And also we did one more, the flags and all our pledges. I tell you, some of these kids, man, they are just like my own. I mean, when they are here, they are like our kids. You know, we watch over them. Boys will be boys, like they say, but each and every one of them has a purpose, a plan, and a calling. And I just love you guys. Amen. This is our Ranger Discovery Group. Same thing also. They've learned fingerprinting, tool craft, tools like when they go camping, hiking. We went on a day hike. They learn how to follow correct paths when they're going to hike. Also, Commander Josh has done a great job with them, with Commander Mark, if he's out there. Brother Oliver Lopez is back there, too. He's a parent helper. And Commander Richie Ghani, who's over there with his family every week. Oh, right here, Richie. Sorry. All right. He was over there before. But these are Ranger Discovery boys. Amen.
Amen. I've spoke with these boys, I've worked with these boys, I've heard some wonderful things coming from them, the hearts that they have for the Lord. We are now going to have our honor prims. Stand up with your sponsors and come on up. Our beautiful young ladies. Beautiful.
Okay, I talk again. To be an honor prim means they have completed 18 units. They have done, they have memorized their scripture verses. They have done their activity pages. They have been duct taped. Yeah, we duct taped them on the wall, on the ceiling. No, we really don't do that. I'm sorry. Let me just put it that way. We really don't do that. But that's a joke that we haven't. That's a joke we have in the class. These girls have been with me for 2 years. And these ones on the end, they have been with me for 1 year so far. So they have one more year to go before they're in honor prim. So we have Kayla, we have Victoria, we have Sophia, and we have Jalen. So we present to you 2012-2013 honor prims. Have our two that are going to be honor prims.
I saw the look on Pastor's face as if, like, we're going to talk about this later. Duct tape on the ceiling. Okay. Okay, next is our Adventure Rangers. If you would stand up, come on up with your sponsors.
Greetings. God bless you. These young men that you see here, they are very dedicated. They're always on time. And they learn very, very, very fast. They have gone through to earn their awards and their merits through Romans, the book of Romans, the first book of Corinthians, the second book of Corinthians. They did survival course. They did the bow and arrow. They also did the hawk and knife. It's not an easy task. It's very hard work. But in September, we had a journey. And that journey was to teach them as much as possible. In that journey, they went from Genesis through Revelation. And our theme for Royal Rangers is mentoring boys for Christ. Now, these young boys, in the future, they'll be the future pastors, probably the future evangelists, probably the future teachers. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. For me, it was a privilege and an honor to teach them, because they are teachable. And I just want to say this, and I'll terminate with this. I thank the pastor, and I thank Pastor Mark, because they made it possible to have rooms, beautiful rooms downstairs, for these boys. And these boys are willing and able to do whatever we ask them. And I think that by next year, we can accomplish more. Hopefully, God willing. God bless you.
Amen. I know who I want to be with next time there's a hurricane. These young men. We are getting ready to present our Honor Stars. So I'm going to ask the fathers of the Honor Stars if you would please go to the back of the sanctuary. And then I'm going to ask the Honor Star sponsors to come up and get ready to present.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Ms. Kendra. This is Ms. Quad. We're the star sponsors. All the girls that you're going to be seeing being honored today have completed 27 units, learned 27 Bible verses, did a big test, statement of faith, ABCs of salvation. We just keep instilling the word in them. And we have, I believe, three this year that did 3 years' work in 1 year. So we're very proud of them. So we will get started. First, we have Jayla McBain. Jada has been in the girls' ministry program since she's been at Rainbows, and her favorite verse is Galatians 5, 22 and 23.
God, keep your hand upon me.
Keep your hand upon me, and no evil can.
Mercy Turner. Mercy Turner's been in the girls' ministry since Rainbows. Her favorite verse is John 3:16.
Next up, we have Ruth Abraham. She started girls' ministries this year. She completed 3 years of work in 1 year. And her favorite verse is John 3:16 as well.
Naomi Turner. Her favorite verse is John 3:16, and she's been in girls' ministry since Rainbows.
Next up, we have Justine Dunnigan. She's been in girls' ministry since Prims, and her favorite verse is John 3:16.
Zainab Sulemi, her favorite verse is 3:16, and she did 3 years' work in 1 year.
Next, we have Jelana Daniels. Her favorite verse is also John 3:16. This is the third young lady that we had that did 3 years' work in 1 year. We're going to have Miss Jessie come up to give the girls the honor charge.
In Stars Club, you have been taught and trained in Christian principles and doctrine. May the scriptures you have memorized give you a strong foundation and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. Unmovable and unchangeable, regardless of what comes in your way in life. You have great choices ahead of you. Always consider what Jesus would have you do and follow his leading. I charge you to stand firm as an honest star, to keep your eyes on Jesus, and to remember your pledge. You know your pledge? You can recite your pledge now. Very good. Jesus has a special purpose and plan for your lives. You know that, right? Yes? Yes. He will never fail you.
God, keep your hand.
Keep your eyes on him and your hand. Put your right hand up. Your hand in his. Walk close to the Lord. And your motto? Your motto loud? Did you hear that? May your commitment to follow Jesus direct your every step. We present to you 2012-2013 Honor Stars.
Now we have a special PowerPoint presentation for you. We want to share with you the 2012-2013 season, Girls Ministries and Royal Rangers. Presentation. Obviously, a little technical difficulties. So while I have a minute, I'm going to plug the Inspire concert next Saturday. It's a wonderful family event, community event. Invite your friends, invite everybody. It's just going to be an evening of inspiration and encouragement. It's going to be our wonderful children's ministry. Our youth are going to be speaking. Our dance ministry is going to minister to us. Our choir, it's going to be in Spanish. It's going to be in Korean. It's going to be in English. So come on out, and we're ready.
Keep your hand upon me.
Amen. So we're getting ready for our final and our most special presentation. So I'm going to stall a little bit and also encourage you to talk to Mr. Marco and talk to Miss Jessica. We need your help. We can go so far with these girls and these boys. You can see the work that's been done with such a small amount of help. Three men have done all of this in 1 year. Imagine what we can do if more of you men stepped up, where we can take them, where they can go, camping trips. This is not the future. This is today. They can go into the schools where you can't go, and they can preach the word. These girls can shine their lights wherever they go. They go places that we can never go. And so we must prepare them. So pray about it. Come talk to me, Miss Jessica or Mr. Marco. I'm going to ask you to prepare your hearts. Miss Quad and Miss Jessica have a special presentation. They are going to take us to the King as they minister in dance. Keep talking because they're not ready. Okay. What else? We have a lot. We have a very busy summer. We want to impact our community this summer. So if you stop by the children's kiosk, you can see a list. We have a fun day coming up. You can invite your friends and your family to that and get to know everybody. Hot dogs and rides and even a petting zoo. And we have a family movie night coming up with lots of fun. Pastor, did I forget to tell you about the petting zoo? Oops. Oops. I heard that. No. Anyway, okay, I'm in trouble again. And we have a movie day coming up. We have our child's evangelism group coming, and I believe that we are ready. Prepare your hearts.
Options are few. I'm trying to pray, but where are you? I'm all churched out, hurt and abused. I can't fake what's left to do.
Come on.
Truth is I'm no strength to fight, no tears to cry, even if I tried, but still my soul refuses to die.
My offering,
oh, lay me at the throne,
leave me there,
leave me there.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes, give the Lord a clap offering, guys. You see, praise him. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord God, you are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says, give honor to honor is due. And every leader, every commander, every helper, every assistant, that's exactly what they do every week. They take your children to the king. They do it with laughter and joy and pizza and puzzles and smiles and crafts. But these, our children are learning the foundations of the love of God. I read somewhere that a good childhood can never be replaced. And this church has put their hands on the plow to say we care about our kids. Oh, they sound like kids, they act like kids, because they are kids. And those of you, you and I, we know that life will swoom in quick enough. Why, life will come, the bills will happen, the problems, you know, but this church has covered the children to give them this season. Those people every Friday night who show up, who leave looking for aspirin, right? Right, Brother Mark? Go home and say, I don't know, this is the last week I'm going back to that. I'm just, wow, that's like pandemonium. But they still come back. And they do it because they love your children. So I want us to give honor who honor is due. And I'd like all the commanders, the leaders, the helpers, the assistants, will you stand to your feet? Let this body see who you are. Sue, will you stand to your feet? Marco, all the leaders, missionettes. Yeah, say thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. 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 You may be seated. We're going to close with prayer in just a moment. We're going to ask the Lord to bless these children. The book of Mark, chapter 10, Jesus said, hinder not the little children to come unto me. And this is what we've put our hands to do tonight, church. We hinder not the little children to come to him. And I thank you for the sacrifice, for the commitment that you make so my children, so my son, my daughter can come home and sing a song and a scripture. Thank you. So I'm going to ask, if you're a ranger, a missionette, will you stand to your feet? Prims, daisies, will you stand up? Thank you. Now I want to pray for you. So girls, if you can look over here, and boys. The other day I went to visit Pastor. I went to visit the boys' room, and I went to visit the girls. Now, Miss Jessica was sitting down with all the girls and girls only and girls ministry. They were all sitting in a circle, and she was teaching what a promise meant. Then I went to the boys. Hallelujah. Praise God. A lot of energy in those boys, but I have to admit it was a pizza night. Let's pray for our kids, church. Amen. Hallelujah. Stretch out your hand. Father, we thank you for the children that you have given ICC. Father, we thank you that we know that if a church isn't crying, it's dying, Lord God. So I thank you for the children that you have put in this body. Father, your word says in the book of Acts, your spirit fell on all flesh, God. These children have gifts, abilities, calling, skill. And Father, I pray that you raise up a hedge of protection around these children, that they may know you all the days of their life, God. And they will walk with you, Father, forever your path has for them, Lord God. Lead them with a fear, an understanding, a respect for you, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, that the young ladies will grow and be exactly what you've called them to be. Father, there's mothers, there's wives, there's grandmas, there's leaders, Father, in this group, and I thank you for them. I pray for the young boys, Lord, They will grow to be men, fathers, and husbands, and they will follow you. Father, as we, as adults, as parents, hand down a heritage, may we hand this baton, Lord God, to our children that will hold up the faith. And Father, we will not be ashamed of the gospel, for we will hand it from generation to generation to generation. Bless our children and bless this church. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's people said, amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Praise God. God bless you, church. We thank you for coming out tonight and celebrating the life of our children. Be blessed. Go home safe. God loves you. Amen.